Today, we dive into the history of the Joker and reveal Gotham's weirdly large infestation of clown children underneath him. Stay tuned. Hey guys, my name is DJ, and the Joker has gone through a whole array of controversial and shocking stories. If you can take a character, have him cut his own face off, and have it only be one of the most shocking things he's done, then you know a character has seen and done it all in his time. However, if you've looked at comic book Twitter over the past few weeks, then you might have seen this image floating around. Now, for a character who has seemingly done everything they could possibly do in their past 85 years of existence, I will say that even that picture on Twitter caught me a bit off guard. But while there are plenty of thoughts and arguments people have made surrounding this image, I personally don't really see it as that big of a deal, especially after taking it upon myself to actually go and read the comic just to find out what the hell is going on. For those who don't know, after flirting with DC's resident magician Zatanna, the Joker said that he essentially wanted to start a family with her. However, obviously, Zatanna rejected this because it's the Joker. So she decided to cast a spell that would make women repulsed at the idea of having his baby. But magic can be a funny thing sometimes, and what Zatanna actually did was make the Joker pregnant. So naturally, just a few panels later, Joker gave birth. Kind of. Instead of having a traditional birth, he ended up puking out this weird mud monster that would transform to resemble the Joker. However, while that story seems a bit odd, hell, it's even odd in the comic with the whole thing feeling sort of imaginary, I will say that the idea of the Joker having a child isn't all that strange. Is it weird in this context? Sure, but the idea of the Joker having a child is strangely not that foreign of a concept. In fact, throughout the years, there have been several examples of the Joker having a child, or at the very least, having someone take inspiration from him to become a makeshift child of the Clown Prince of Crime. So today, I decided to explore Gotham's seedy underbelly and try to find these so-called children of the Joker. And while we'll get some more literal examples of the Joker's children in a little bit, I want to first turn our attention over to someone who's decided to take inspiration from Gotham's resident killer clown. So much so that she would end up calling herself the Joker's daughter. The Joker's daughter, also known as Dula Dent, first appeared in the 1970s as essentially a female version of the Joker. She would commit crimes in his name, and Batman and Robin would try to defeat her. However, to call Dula Dent Joker's daughter around this time would mean just as much as calling her, I don't know, Catwoman's daughter. Oh, I guess she did that. Okay, it would mean just as much as calling herself Scarecrow's daughter. Penguin's daughter? Riddler's daughter? Okay, what the hell is going on? That's right, around this time, Dula Dent's whole shtick was that she would commit crimes on behalf of Gotham's infamous lineup of criminals. However, after much confusion, Dula was actually revealed to be the daughter of notorious Gotham criminal, Two-Face. After Two-Face abandoned her as a child, Dula grew up to emulate other villains as she searched for herself among the chaos. Which, in its own right, is kind of an interesting story. I kind of like the idea of this ultimate copycat criminal going around Gotham at this time. But the story doesn't quite end there because a lot of stuff kinda happened. You see, DC has a lot of reset events where their entire universe gets reset or completely changes. And with those events comes very drastic changes to certain characters, which is exactly what happened to Dula with the New 52 reboot. They hit the reset button on her and decided to focus more on her being this intense follower of the Joker rather than a perpetual copycat villain. After the New 52 reset, Dula became a drastically different and darker character. She was completely unstable with this reboot, and so, naturally, she saw the Joker as a spiritual father figure. So, when she found the Joker's previously cut off face lying around in the sewers, Dula decided to sew it on top of her face as a symbol that the Joker's spirit continues to live on. She became obsessed with him, killing everyone in his honor and being in total denial about his previous death. Yeah, the New 52 brought a ton of dark and gritty characters to life, and Dula was a major example of this. Essentially taking this copycat idea and turning it into a sick and twisted villain. However, Duala isn't the only person influenced by the Joker's madness. But sadly, this next person wasn't influenced in the same way. While Duala chose the Joker as her spiritual father figure, Tim Drake was sadly poisoned into becoming his successor. In one of the all-time great superhero animated movies titled Batman Beyond Return of the Joker, there is a horrifying flashback that would scar the Tim Drake Robin for the rest of his life. Decades before the movie takes place, the infamous duo of Joker and Harley Quinn would kidnap Tim Drake. That is, before inflicting weeks of torture and brainwashing on him at the abandoned Arkham Asylum. Throughout the weeks of torture, Tim was altered by the Joker's chemicals into looking like a mini-me version of him. A fight ensued following Batman and Batgirl's arrival to Arkham, where Tim ended up killing the Joker before suffering a complete nervous breakdown. After this, Tim was understandably forced into retirement by Bruce, who blamed himself for the whole ordeal, severing ties with his former Robin. But the story doesn't stop there. Now, I'm going to spoil the ending of Batman Beyond Return of the Joker, and if you plan on seeing the movie, I highly recommend just skipping to this timestamp right here on my titties. So at the end of the movie, after that confrontation at Arkham Asylum, it is revealed that the Joker is still alive. Kind of. The Joker, during those weeks of torture, implanted a genetic-based microchip into Tim. This microchip allowed the Joker to actually transform Tim into the deranged and psychopathic clown of Gotham. The Joker would still be able to live on across time in the vessel of this former Robin. Of course, the Terry McGinnis version of Batman would stop him. Sure, Tim Drake wasn't technically a child of the Joker, but in a way, he transformed Tim into becoming the next Joker, so I'm counting it here. After all, there are those parents out there who have children to continue on their legacy, and that's essentially what the Joker was trying to do. But of course, the Joker isn't the only crazy clown running through the streets of Gotham, nor is Tim the only person the Joker has ever fully transformed with his toxic chemicals. The Joker also has his lovely partner in crime, with Harley Quinn causing chaos alongside him. However, obviously, I'm not going to count her as a child of Joker. But because of Harley Quinn and that romance she has with the Joker, he technically does have a child roaming the world. Now, originally, I was going to talk about Harley Quinn's pregnancy test debacle in Arkham City, where there is a positive pregnancy test in Joker's office before hundreds of negative tests would appear in the same office in the Harley Quinn's Revenge DLC set after the main game. But I mean, that's kind of a short story with no real interesting ending. However, in my research of this topic, I did find that Harley Quinn does have a child with the Joker in the Injustice universe. In this alternate timeline, Harley Quinn would find out that she's pregnant a few years prior to Superman's worldwide domination. So, after deciding that she would keep the baby, Harley left the Joker for almost a year to have their baby in secret. She knew that the Joker would never want a daughter, and that bringing her into this life of crime would be dangerous for her. So, after giving birth to her daughter named Lucy, Harley handed her off to her sister for her to raise. And considering that in this universe, Harley would grow more as a person and leave Joker behind in her past, you can't help but think about how sad Harley must be in this universe. Harley has always been someone to feel a bit sorry for, and this run in the Injustice comics makes her story just that much sadder. To lose your kid so that they don't die by your psychopathic boyfriend's hands? That's really rough. I've always been a fan of Harley, but after learning this fact in the Injustice universe, I can't help but feel even more intrigued by her character. But while Harley had to sacrifice motherhood to protect her child, our final point of discussion was taken away from his mother to be protected by his adopted parents. Lonnie Macon, a young boy growing up in Gotham City, was a pretty smart kid who had a great knowledge of technology. However, like many of those in Gotham, Lonnie saw that Gotham was corrupted and he hated it. So, using his gadgets and his drive toward a better future, he would don his very own costume and take to the streets as Anarchy. But even though he may have had good intentions, Anarchy's methods were a bit too extreme for Batman. And thus, this political activist would become a villain for the Dark Knight. But what exactly does that have to do with the Joker? Well, you see, after a while, Anarchy would search for his birth mother named Greta Mitchell, and she would reveal to him that she used to actually be a member of Joker's gang. And one night, she had an affair with him, which Lonnie was the product of. Of course, Lonnie couldn't believe this at first. However, after confirming with the Joker himself that the affair had indeed happened, Lonnie's entire existence just felt soul-crushing to him. How could Anarchy, a character looking to help the wounded Gotham City, be the son of the most notorious criminal in Gotham history? But then, the story ends. This big twist of the Joker having a son was left as a cliffhanger to a story that sadly never got a proper ending, with the Anarchy series being cancelled. Denny O'Neil, the person who oversaw all the Batman-related books at the time, only agreed to the story if the writers promised to reverse it in 6 months. So the original plan of the story was to have it revealed that Anarchy is actually not the son of the Joker. However, of course, this story was cancelled before this reveal of Anarchy not being the Joker's son. So, it stands. Anarchy is the Joker's son. The Clown Prince of Crime, after so many weird teases, technically has a kid in the DC universe. Why anyone would want to have a kid with him, let alone get intimate enough with him to make a baby? I have no idea. But as you can tell, the Joker's weird and disgusting history has been filled with people who can lay claim to being the Joker's child. Whether it's through someone seeing him as an inspiration, whether it's through long and painful psychological torture, or whether it's through the natural process of childbirth, there are many children throughout Gotham City looking to continue on the legacy of the Clown Prince of Crime. All these children with the misfortune of having their father as the Joker. Thank you all so much for watching this video. I know it's a bit of a weird topic this time, but the idea of someone wanting to have the Joker's child is just so bizarre to me that I had to do my own research on it. And after seeing that picture float around with the Joker being pregnant over on Twitter, I had to do more research on it. But I want to hear from you guys. Do you have anything to add to this bizarre topic? Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and all that good stuff. But until next time, have a good day. Bye-bye.